Hello everyone, Framlingham Debate Society here. Today, in this video, we're going to cover how to improve your debating skills. It is important to have a structured speech when you deliver your case or support your case with arguments. Firstly, you need to define the key terms in a debate motion. For instance, when you have the motion that states that this House believes that the homework should be banned, you need to define the key term like banned and the key term and what do you mean by saying homework. Secondly, you need to state your arguments in a clear order and say which one of them are you going to develop in your further speech. Consequently, finish by reminding the judge and the audience of why your side of the debate should win and provide them with a clear aim.
Hi, I'm Philip, and today I'm going to highlight the importance of research in debate. Research will improve all other aspects of your debate. Research will make your arguments more structured, it will make you more of a diligent speaker, and overall, it will make you more persuasive as a person.
Hi, I'm Rukia, and I'm here to talk to you about a good delivery. What makes a good delivery in a debate? Well, even the greatest of the greatest debate need a good delivery. But what is it? Well, the first important factor of a good delivery is your speech. Your speech should be in a very lively tone, because if it's in a monotone, it'll be very robotic, and that's not very good for your debating motion. Also, the pace of your delivery is very, very crucial, because you shouldn't be talking too fast, because everyone else wouldn't go along with the argument you're making. The second important factor of a very good delivery is your body language. Your body language should include a direct eye contact with your opponents, because this will let them know that you know what you're really talking about. And lastly, confidence is very, very crucial when you're delivering in your debate, because that's what brings life to your argument.
Hi, I'm Poppy, and I'm going to be talking about following the protocol in a debate. Nothing would be more embarrassing or damning to your chances of winning if you do not follow the protocol. For example, knowing when you can offer your points of information, keeping within your time limits, and being respectful and accommodating of your opposition. It can reflect badly on you if you choose to ignore these or be ignorant of them, and the judges may consider them in their final decision. It can be very easy to get carried away and be passionate in the debate, so it's important that you keep yourself disciplined.
Hi, I'm Eliza, and my top tip is why research is important in a debate. Research is important in a debate so that you have statistics and facts to back up your argument. For example, instead of saying that leaving the EU will reduce immigration, a better argument would be that immigration is predicted to reduce by 80% after Brexit. This will give your argument more impact. Secondly, research is important to show that you have a strong understanding and are knowledgeable on the topic of the debate.
I'm Niall, and today I'm going to tell you about logical fallacies. Logical fallacies are an incredibly important part of both debating and argument in general. A logical fallacy is a piece of logic which, while initially appearing to be perfectly sound, upon further scrutiny will likely fall apart immediately. An example of this is the No True Scotsman fallacy. The No True Scotsman fallacy is the fallacy where a person attempts to define a group by a single measure, such as no Christian will support slavery. However, if you were to ask many different Christians, they would not all agree that the only type of Christian is a Christian who does not support slavery. Therefore, this is a no true Scotsman fallacy, as this is an incorrect definition of the group of Christians. To know logical fallacies and utilize them in your arguments will put you at a massive advantage above your opponents, not to mention avoiding them yourselves, as they can be crippling to both your own integrity and that of your argument.
Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed the video and you have learned something. If you did like the video, please like and subscribe for more videos from Framlingham College. Thanks, bye.